Hi everybody, second run. We have discussed before linear motion properties. We have to know that the speed is different from velocity, and the speed is a ratio between distance and time, while the velocity is displacement over time. We have to know kinds of velocity. You have known in prep 3 that velocity is considered as a uniform velocity and non-uniform. If we are starting with a uniform velocity, you have to know that velocity displacement over time is represented in the uniform velocity by a relation between displacement and time and the relation between velocity and time. In displacement and time, the angle inclined within x-axis is constant, which is known that the slope equal tan is theta, so the slope is constant if the angle is constant. If you have to know that the slope is the ratio between the y-axis and the x-axis, so it's a displacement over time, so it's a velocity. So velocity here is constant as the theta is constant. And you have to know if we represent the relation between velocity and time, the theta or the angle inclined between the line and the x-axis is zero. So you have to know it's a zero acceleration. Non-uniform velocity is represented by increasing the velocity or decreasing the velocity. In increasing the velocity, the theta or the angle is curve which represent the increasing of the theta. If the angle increasing, so tan theta is increasing, so the slope is increasing. The slope is represented as y over x, so the velocity is named by the slope, or the slope is velocity, so the velocity also is increasing. If we represent the increasing velocity between a relation between a v and the time, velocity and the time, it will have a straight line relation, so theta is constant, so acceleration is a positive uniform acceleration. Acceleration, if we have to remember that the acceleration is the rate of a change of velocity. If velocity is constant, acceleration is zero. If velocity increase, so the acceleration is positive uniform. If velocity decrease, so the acceleration is negative uniform. Decreasing velocity is represented by a ratio between displacement and time and velocity and time. If we discuss the relation or the ratio between displacement and time, theta is decreasing until it reaches zero. The theta or the angle, again, it's an angle inclined between the slope or the curve and the x-axis. So here the theta between the curve and the x-axis decreasing until at the end point of the curve, if we take a tangent, it will have a zero angle between the curve and the x-axis. If we are talking about the relation between the velocity and the time, it's a negative acceleration. Why it's a negative? If we are calculating the slope in this relation, it will have a negative value. So the linear motion, again, will have a linear motion, will have a uniform velocity, which is displacement with time, and velocity with time, uniform, has a constant theta and zero theta. Increasing velocity, which is displacement to time and velocity to time, increasing velocity has increasing theta between distance and time and constant theta between velocity and time. Decreasing velocity, which is displacement with time and velocity with time, displacement with time has decreasing theta, so decreasing velocity. Velocity with time has a constant theta but in the negative direction, so it's a negative acceleration. Linear motion has another kinds of velocity, which is instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity, to get the velocity at required instant. If the velocity is uniform, we represented it before by a straight line relation of constant theta. Constant theta, so constant velocity, so the v instantaneous at any point is constant. So the v instantaneous equate or equal to velocity at any point. If velocity is non-uniform, you have to take a point which has a required instant. At this point, you will take a tangent on this point and then take any random two point on the tangent, make a triangle of the slope between these two points, then make a triangle of a slope, determine the slope y2 minus y1 x2 over minus x1, so the velocity of the instant or the instantaneous velocity equate with the slope. Linear motion has other kind of velocity, which is average velocity. If the velocity is uniform or constant, at any point the velocity is constant, so the v average on the whole trip will be equal to the velocity at any point, and also equal with the v instantaneous at any instant. If the velocity non-uniform, you will take the total displacement and the total time. So we have to discuss an example on a car starting its motion by increasing its velocity. So between the distance and time, the AB points or AB trip, the theta is increasing, so you have to know that the velocity is increasing. AB dt relation is theta is increasing, so the velocity is increasing. So it's a non-uniform velocity as the theta is not constant. In vt relation, the theta is constant. In AB, theta is constant, so the acceleration is positive uniform. The acceleration is ratio between velocity and time. In BC period, the theta is constant, so the velocity is constant as the slope between D and T is velocity. VT relation, BC, the theta is zero, so the acceleration is zero. In CD relation, the theta is decreasing. In DT relation, CD period, in DT relation, the theta is decreasing, so the velocity is decreasing. And VT relation, the theta is constant but in negative direction, so the acceleration is negative uniform. Thank you for audience.